paintings that touch the bottom of people's heart. Artworks by acclaimed painter He Jialin not only show the beautiful landscapes of China, but also reflect his profound love and nostalgia. Unrestrained and elegant. Through various strokes, his paintings present a sense of poetic beauty.
我是一个山水画家，从小就热爱祖国的山山水水。自从学画以来啊，我就选择了山水画这门专业。在以后的日子里，我又常常在祖国的大好河山去写生，用手中的画笔去描绘我们的最美好的山山水水。
Showing a talent for painting at a young age, He Jialin's painting Ruggedness of Autumn won the gold medal of the first Chinese landscape painting exhibition when he was 32 years old.
这幅秋气嶙峋当时在画的过程当中有很多这种山的脉络我特意把它画得比较重但是呢它这个重的地方突然断掉了又和下面其他的山又呼应起来所以它有一种在空气当中相互构成的这么一种关联当时我画完这幅作品的时候我的父亲是第一个观众他说啊，你这个画的不是我们地球上的山水他说好像是外星球上的山水我当时我就很得意
我要的就是这个效果
哎，对我当时就这个想法
Besides creating paintings, He Jialin also has a deep interest in playing the traditional Chinese instrument, the guqin. For him, music, especially traditional Chinese music, can offer inspiration and artistic cultivation.
有三十多年了，对于古琴的文化的一种了解，我觉得对我们画画的人来讲是非常重要的。因为无声处有很多你想象的空间。我们画画的时候大部分学画一开始都喜欢画得满满的其实不是画面里面一定要留有一定的虚要有一定的空要有一定的白让人们去参与去想象
那除了抚琴之外您是不是还有其他的爱好呢
爱好非常多平时喜欢写写诗搞一些收藏还喜欢下棋
The combination of painting, poetry, and calligraphy in He Jialin's artworks can leave a lasting impression. Besides self-cultivation, He Jialin has special interest in portraying China's countryside. His paintings are more than art, they're an expression of the heart.
This is a painting made of Shangri-La, Li Su Zu, this old village. When I画这个桥上的这群羊的时候啊，我就感觉我就是其中的一只羊，在这个木桥上欢快地跳舞，在表现这些树木的时候，我还是真是挺犯愁的。为了表现它的这种新时代、新精神、新面貌，所以我就想用一些比较带有符号的一种语言去表现。所以我把它这种树叶跟这种树枝树干错落使画面产生一种灿烂的光怪陆离的视觉效果。
何嘉玲's artistic style is deeply influenced by his childhood experiences. He was born in 1961 in Yangzhou, Jiangsu province. At a young age, he moved with his father to northwest China,where he lived in Baoji, Shaanxi province for 10 years and enjoyed a carefree life. In 1975, as his father changed jobs, he returned to Hangzhou with his parents. When they passed through Shanghai, his mother bought a 12-color watercolor paint set for him. From then on, he devoted himself to Chinese traditional ink art.In 1977, He Jialin graduated from high school, just in time for the resumption of the National College Entrance Exam. But he didn't take part, as he was not very skilled in science subjects. Instead, He Jialin took up a variety of jobs. He worked very hard and was determined to change his life. In his short novel named The Candle, he wrote about a self-taught amateur painter.
我第一个工作是倒垃圾。
嗯，
我们杭州这个有一个人民玻璃厂，他们那些玻璃的碎片，我要把它倒到十几里以外的很大的一个垃圾坑里面去。所以一天大概这个来回也就三四趟，第二年呢又到轮船码头，要上岸的这些麻包里面全都是这种海里面的鱼，那么我们要从船上搬到这个冷库里面。最后我又找了一份临时工，在运河边上的一个小猪的集散地，给其他地方来买小猪的那些农民去挑各种各样的猪，比如说这个是长白种，那个是金花两头乌，当时都如数家珍。
嗯，
做这份工作的时候，我就写了一篇自己看的小说，叫《
竹》。
当时心智是很苦的，因为你看不到前途，所以只能把自己的精神寄托放在自己的小说里面，用那个竹来表达自己对未来的期待。
In 1979, at the age of 18, He Jialin saw an advertisement in a piece of newspaper for enrolling students at Hangzhou Westlake Fine Arts School, and he signed up. However, after studying for a few days, he found that his art skills were different than the rest of the class. He studied even harder, and 1 year later, his performance improved so much, he was considered better than his peers.In 1984, He Jialin was admitted to the then Zhejiang Academy of Fine Arts, mainly focusing on Chinese landscape painting. He cherished the opportunity and tried his best to learn new things. Most of his early works depict Northwest China where he lived as a child, including some award-winning pieces, including The Soul of a Sacred Mountain. But all these achievements did not make him complacent.He continued to innovate in the field of landscape painting.
首先我喜欢山山水水，比如说我小时候在宝鸡生活，一边是秦岭山，一边是黄土高坡，尤其是到了冬天，秦岭山顶上白雪皑，秦岭山是青灰色的，而黄土高坡上面平面上的白雪皑却是黄的和白的之间的分明。那么在那个环境里头啊，我就喜欢经常去爬山涉水，它让我对大自然的这种美啊特别的敏感了。再加上小时候去看一些人民画报，哎，能看到傅抱石、李可染先生他们画的那些山水画，哎呀，我就觉得特别有意思，所以自然而然的就喜欢上了这个山水画。尤其是杭州这个当时叫浙江美术学院，现在叫中国美术学院，山水专业又是最强的一个专业，所以当时毫不犹豫地就选择了山水画。
In 1994, He Jialin was admitted to the China Academy of Art for a master's degree. During this period, he met his mentor, Mr. Tong Zhongtao, a master of landscape art. Tong's teaching style was unique. Instead of teaching painting techniques, Tong inspired He Jialin to learn how to observe and think in a critical way.He Jialin was encouraged to read books such as philosophy and history in his spare time, which benefited him a great deal in his later artistic career. In 2004, He Jialin graduated from the Chinese Painting Department of the China Academy of Art with a doctorate degree. His painting, Colors of a Misty Mountain, won the Silver Award in the 10th National Exhibition of Fine Arts, making a successful conclusion to his doctoral career.
当时真的不太理解，说心里话，读研究生嘛，总想多学点画画上的技巧。但是呢，童老师上课的第一天就给我开了一个书单，里面全是折纸类的东西。这些书呢，有些都没有听说过。那么久而久之以后，就养成我喜欢看这类书的习惯，然后从中呢要想出自己的想法。有时候我跟童老师两个人在学术上会有争论的，因为可能年轻气盛嘛。有一次我跟童老师说，我说哎呀，上次我们这个争论，人家都反映到戏里说我和您吵架了。哎，他说学术就应该要有争鸣。后面这几十年啊，我真的非常的受益，我越到后来越感觉到童老师过去呢4年对我的培养，到今天 还一直用不完。
From the mid-1990s, He Jialin sketched the gardens around the West Lake in Hangzhou and the water towns in Jiangsu and Zhejiang provinces. In 2011, at the age of 50, He Jialin left Hangzhou, where he had been working and living for more than 30 years, and moved north to the China National Academy of Painting in Beijing. It was a turning point, not only for his life, but also for his painting style.Since then, his landscape painting has focused more on the mountains and rivers in northern China, giving viewers a feel of vastness and boundlessness. He also emphasizes the role of traditional culture in creating artworks.
当时我们在画写生的时候，我就要求我们的学生多去关注当地的文化，甚至我给他们做导读，我都告诉他们这个房子当时这个结构为什么这么建，啊，这个村落的格局为什么是这样设置的。在一个南方的一个古村落，我在那个村落里走了一下，突然发现在很多瓦砾当中啊，有一半露出外面有这个，我开头以为是一个瓷片呢，我就把它捡起来，后来发现它是一个瓷砚。我们可以想象，就是当年在那个村落里面那些农村的孩子，他们要读书，他们要进京赶考，他们在灯下挑灯研墨，让我感受到了与古人交流的这么一瞬间。
In recent years, He Jialin has been sketching all over China, visiting many ancient villages located deep in the mountains.He hopes to use his brush to record them in a poetic way.
We 接着一步幻景啊，继续画中游。我们都知道中国的很多古老村寨啊，都极富特点。比如说像位于黔东南苗族侗族自治州黎平县的赵兴侗寨，就是一个既有着悠久历史又有着淳朴民风的古寨。我知道2017年何老师也专门去到那里进行了写生，创作了一系列的作品。
我在作品当中呢，我是以这个笔线作为一个主要的表现语言，那么在左右啊这个对岸不同的房屋的时候，我有虚和实的处理，然后桥底下有些碎的石头，让它溪水从石头上流过，我觉得就是这样的一个环境啊，让我能够感受到这样一个古老的村落它给你带来的这种文化氛围。这幅作品呢，它实际上是那次我带的学生到贵州仁怀写生，那次写生我最大的收获就是在现场面对着我所看到的这样的古村落，然后我冥想，包括它的建筑，包括它的这个山坡，以及包括它山坡前面的这种静景的一些树木，我都用一些比较音乐的一些比较装饰的啊比较淡雅的方式让这些作品平面化。这样的一种语言给你带来的感受一定是要有一种清新自然而比较明朗的这样的一种意境。20年前我去过浙江兰溪的诸葛八卦村，这个村子很有特点，在村子的中间有一个像太极一样的水塘，四周的村寨建着围绕着这个水塘形成一个八卦的一个图形。就在那一刻啊，我自己明显感觉到我们过去的古代这种村落不单是我们赖以生存可以居住的这么一个环境，其实它还是我们村落文明和诗意居住的归宿。从那以后啊，我就开始啊就是对我们的古村落进行考察写生，我画了许多关于古村落的一些作品，乐此不疲。在画这些作品的时候，一方面了解更多的我们的历史，我们村落的文明的过去，同时呢也让自己在笔墨语言上有更多的突破和更多的探索和发现。所以 我想我在我今后的写生创作当中，我将会继续用我自己手中的画笔去表现这些古老的村落，留住我们的乡愁。
李琼 CGTN。